Why do dictators often end up having bloated capital cities? In this video, I'll give you a simple model that explains the distribution of government goodies that can help explain this fact. So, you get to be a dictator for the day, with a fixed supply of cash to hand out to your capital and to the countryside. You've stolen a lot too, but we'll assume that's been taken out of the equation. We'll assume first that the size of these two regions is fixed, as they would be if you were a really powerful leader who could stop migration to the city. We'll put on the x-axis the share of government goodies that are going to the capital city. Now we're going to assume a curve that represents the impact that an extra dollar spent in the city has on increasing your probability of survival in office. It starts high and then declines, because eventually the urbanites get a little sated with bread and circuses. We'll draw a similar line for the marginal impact of a dollar spent in the country on the probability of survival. That, of course, is increasing with the number of dollars you spend in the city, because as you spend more in the city, you spend less in the country, and that causes the extra effect of a dollar in the country to increase. The right spending strategy equalizes the marginal impact of a dollar in the two areas. But here's the crucial assumption. I've drawn the impact line in a country far below the line in the capital, because distance means protection. You're not going to be impacted by a rural revolt nearly as much as by an urban uprising. So you get less bang for your buck by spending in the countryside, and consequently you spend less. The result of this little calculation is that the smart dictator targets his money toward the capital, where he can keep his near neighbors satisfied and less likely to rise up against him. But, I hear you cry, won't this cause people to move to the city? And won't that ultimately create more danger for the dictator? Of course it will, at least if the dictator can't stop migration. So this would shift the curves a bit. The impact of spending in the city on the probability of urban revolt shifts downward, since there is the offsetting impact of attracting more unruly migrants. The impact of spending in the country on the probability of a rural revolt perhaps shifts downward as well, but as long as the migration impact is modest, the basic point remains. As long as capital cities are more dangerous to dictators, they will direct disproportionate resources to their capitals, and imperial cities will grow large.